Hey, what's up, screen printers? Welcome to another video tutorial brought to you by learnhowtoscreenprint.com. In today's video, we're going to do Photoshop for screen printing, and I'm going to show you some useful tips to make sure that your film positive and your color separations come out nice and crisp when you get on the press. So we're going to go ahead and jump right in. I've got a JPEG opened up here, and when I get ready to do my color separations, one of the first steps you need to take is to make sure that the image is going to be the same size that you're going to output to film positives. So like right now we've got this 12 inches wide by 17 inches tall and the resolution 300. I like to make sure the resolution is at least 300. That way the color separations come out nice and crisp and your film positives are nice and crisp too. So just make sure the design, the image size is, you know, the same size you're going to output to film positives. That's the first step. And make sure your resolution is 300. All right, click OK. And right now I've got this, everything's flattened. We'll go over here to layers. Everything's on one layer. And let's say we're going to print this on a black shirt. It doesn't always mean that you have to take the black out of the design if you're going to go on a black shirt. And I'll show you what I'm talking about here. We'll go over to channels and we'll do the color separations, and you'll see it's not always necessary to get rid of the background color. Start with that. So right off the bat, we need to start pulling these colors out of here. Let's go up to select color range. Let's click on this red here. All right, so over here in the color range tool, you have the fuzziness slider, and that's going to allow you to select more or less of a particular color. So if you look down in there, we're pulling the brighter red and a little bit of that darker shade of red there. Let's go ahead and keep it just like that. Click OK. And now you see we've got the marching ants around the color. They have the channels panel open here. We're going to save the selection as a channel. Now I'm going to open that. So the color that I selected, it's the foreground color here. And I'm going to go ahead and get this hex color here. Control C, we'll copy that. And so now we'll take this channel, double click it, we'll turn it into a spot color. Click the color there. Now I'm going to hit Control V down there. And now what that is doing is making sure that spot color is the exact same color that we picked. And let's show you one more step. So you know, this color here, we need to figure out the closest color to the Pantone solid coated color swatches. Got my book there. So it said the closest color was 1797C. Okay, we'll click OK. And for the solidity of the color, we're going to drop that down to, we'll say 5%. The colors of your Plastisol ink, without a white underbase, they're going to be pretty translucent. They're not going to be very opaque. So that's why we drop that down to 5%. I'm going to click OK. Hit Control D. It's going to deselect everything. So we'll go back up to the RGB here. And we will proceed with the next color. Let's select color range. And when you first open up the color range, it's probably going to be something similar to this. Make sure you click the invert because you're, you know, making a film positive. So let's pick this white here. Select invert. Now, as you can see, we've got the white, but then we've got a little bit of this tan color here. We're going to back that white off a little bit. Call this the highlight white. OK. Marching ants, they're selecting all the white. Now you want to save selection as a channel. Double click that there. And for here, just want to drag the color picker over to white. They don't have a white in the Pantone library here. So you can, you know, go up and down. There's no just solid white. White is white. Go back to picker. Drag that over. And the highlight white, you know, after you've hit the white base and then you're coming back with the highlight white, that's going to make that pretty white. I mean, you can go 100% here. For the solidity, We'll call this highlight white. Click OK. Go back up to the RGB. Control D, it's going to deselect. So now we want to go with another color. Select color range. Let's pull that tan real quick. All right, so now we're pulling into the highlight white. So let's back that off, back it off, back it off, back it off. Back it off. There you go. Double click that. Control C. Save selection as a new channel. Double click that. Control V. So now we pasted the hex color code from the foreground color, and we'll make this a Pantone. So it's saying the closest Pantone color to that hex code was Pantone 7534C. Click OK. Solidity, same thing, save 5%. Control D. All right, so now let's let me hit Control V. Alright, follow along. Down here in the bottom of the channel, so we're going to click the plus, create new channel, and we're going to double click that, change that to full black. As you can see, the black automatically changes up here in the channel options, and we'll make this 100%. We'll just, instead of black, we'll call this shirt color. Click OK. So now we'll drag that up above the first color there. Turn on that first one. Now, you can barely see it, and that's because, you know, if we printed plastisol ink directly onto a black shirt and there's no white underbase, it's going to be pretty much like that. It's going to be very translucent. And we have the highlight white, and then we have that last color. So now, what we need to do is make white under the red and under the brown. So we will show you how to do that here. So for the highlight white, I'm going to click that, and I'm going to duplicate channel. We'll call this white base. Drag that up. And now to add the other colors. So one of the first steps I like to do here is to duplicate this channel, this color here. We'll just call that red, that way it's not confusing. And so now I want to make this red a little bit smaller when I add it to the white underbase. That way, when I go to print this, the actual red, I want the white not peeking out. I don't need the white underbase peeking out there. So I'm going to control click on the layer's eye there, the channel thumbnail. Control click, and that selects everything inside that channel there. So now I'm going to go to edit, stroke, and we're going to make this 3 pixels. So make sure that this is white, and what that is doing, it's basically choking the red in this. So click OK, hit Control D. So now let's see. Alright, it might be a little bit confusing, but so this is the actual red, the spot color red, and this is the copy that we made to add it to the white underbase. So if you look, it's a little bit smaller than the actual red. See that when I turn the red on, off. So now let's add this red to that white base. So click on the white base channel there. And we'll go to image, apply image, click the red, and there you are. So another thing that you can do is to try a different opacity here. You know, let's say 75. So if you take a look down there, when I went from 100, and I'll show you again, there's 100. Back this off to 75. See that? Right in the door panel there. So Alright, so if I added 100% of that other channel, the red, to the white base, and you take a look up here in the info panel, it's going to show you some stuff you need to know. The info panel. Right now, if I hover over this part, it's saying it's 43%. So that means the white underbase will be 43% right there. Now if we drop this to 75, that would be 32%. So we'd be printing 32% white underbase right there. Which, that red's a little bit darker, so I'm okay with that. Let's go ahead and do that. That way we can get different shades of red. And we're just doing that with white underbase and controlling the amount of ink or the density of the ink that we're laying down there on the underbase. So click OK. Now we need to do that exact same thing that we did with the red. We're going to do that to the brown. So let's go to the brown channel. Duplicate. We'll call this brown. Click OK. So now I'm going to control click on the channel thumbnail, and that's selecting everything in that channel. Let's go up to edit, stroke, and since this is so fine detailed there, we're going to change this to 2 pixels instead of 3. That should be enough of a choke. Click OK, control D. So now I go back to the white underbase. Add the turn on the shirt color there. And so now let's do the exact same thing. With the white underbase channel selected, go to image, apply image. And from this channel here, drop that down to brown. And just to kind of show you, go over that again. Let's say this was, we're going to do 50%. I think there was brown right in here. So if we did 50%, then that's saying, hey, that'd be 50% underbase right there. Now, if we get out to press and we're actually only printing 50% under that light brown, it's not going to make it the same opacity. So let's say we drop this, or excuse me, bump it up to 90%. All right, so there you've got 90%. I think that'd be just fine. We'll keep it at 90. Click OK. Zoom in here. Now if you see that, the black in there, that's where we choked the top colors before we added them to the white underbase. That way, I'll turn them on. That way when you're printing, they're not, the white underbase isn't peeking out. That right there, see that? That difference in the color? That is the Pantone 7534. Falling off of the white underbase. Exact same thing with the red there. Alright. So, have a highlight white. And there you have it. So now we've done this color separation, and we didn't even delete the background color. We've got a white base. Excuse me, there's a shirt color, the white base, the red, highlight white, and the brown. So when we actually get out to press, let's go ahead and delete these last two channels. We don't need these. We want to print from light to dark. We're going to delete these RGB channels too. So you got white base, and then the next color we'd print would actually be brown. Then we'll go red, flash it, and then hit it with the highlight white. And that's it. Now you've got a nice underbase. You got your separations. And from here, we would go to File. Actually, let's turn off the shirt color first. We need to add the registration marks. And I've got that in a separate video, how to add registration marks and print film positives. Let's just show you. We'll skip that step. Go ahead and check out that video if you want to learn how to add your own custom registration marks inside Photoshop. So we click File, Print, and in this window here, for us, we print to an AccuRip, and then the AccuRip will send it to the Epson PA800. And make sure you have, for the color handling, make sure you have separations. 9 times out of 10 when you first, start doing this, it's going to say, Printer manages colors. No, you need separations. and it's kind of not seeing everything there. So let's click Print Settings, Advanced. That's 12.25. Looks like we're about 17. Our AccuRip, it'll send it over to the Epson P800, and it will convert the design where it needs to be halftones into halftones. We've already got that set up inside AccuRip. I think for this design here, I'd probably keep it at 55 LPI. And that's it, man. So now you've did some color separations inside Photoshop, and using the info panel, always keep that open. That way you can see the amount of ink in that particular in that channel. Sometimes when you actually print the film positives, it might have been at, you know, the color, the density, the black might have been at 50%. And if it was 50%, it's going to print off, you know, as halftones. Let's say it was at 80%. And same thing, you know, it's not going to be like a full solid black opaque print. You're going to see halftones in it, and that's because you may have only added, you know, 80% of color to that channel. So keep this open, the info panel. You'll, you know, need that. So thanks for watching this video tutorial. I've got some of these color separations over on our website, learnhowtoscreenprint.com. And if you like this design here, I've got this on our Amazon merch. So, you know, hey, check out our Amazon merch. And that's another way you can make money. Nice passive income is uploading a design, one of your designs, to Amazon. When people buy it, Amazon will print it with a DTG, and then you sit back and collect a royalty. So I've got a link to our Amazon merch. Just head on over to the website, learnhowtoscreenprint.com, and then you can see the link to this design on Amazon. So thanks for watching this video tutorial. Till next time, happy printing.